Yo, what's going on? It's your boy, Mr. Locario, the bad boy of the dating game. What's good? So, I had a guy on my membership program who asked me a question. He wanted to know, like, you know, how can you tell if a girl is basically down to fuck and, you know, make shit happen? And also, he wanted to know, you know, what's the quickest way to get a chick back to your spot to smash and all of that. And remember, guys, if you are on my bad boy membership program, you can send me questions and I will answer them for free. All right. So basically, when it comes to understanding or seeing if a chick is down to fuck, let me first say this. Most chicks are down to fuck. I want to say all, but, you know, the all police are going to come after me and be like, you can't say all, you're generalizing. I'm like, okay, so I'm just saying most chicks are down to fuck. What you got to realize is that most of them want to fuck. But the question is, do they want to fuck you? Are they down to fuck you? Okay. So for example, a chick might be down to fuck you, but she's not down to fuck me. And vice versa. So I just want to put that out there so that you know that, you know, generally chicks are down to fuck. So it's like, you know, is she trying to fuck you? That's the question. So I don't want you to think like, oh, there's a select few of women out here who's down to fuck, and I have to find those only I'm on a quest to find the women who are down to fuck. No, these chicks want to fuck out here. You understand what I'm saying? But the thing is, when it comes to, you know, I guess signs of seeing if a chick is down to fuck, it's basically just two things or two ways it's going to, you know, like blatantly, that you can blatantly see a sign that it's going to go down. And the first way is when a chick that you're dealing with is being sexually aggressive on her own, meaning that let's say if you were on a date or if you met some chick at a bar and y'all are talking, and then let's say, you know, y'all started kissing or you kissed or whatever, and then she starts to grab on your dick and, you know, or she starts to, you know, pull you into the bathroom and, you know, she's being very sexually aggressive with you, that is her, you know, she's down to fuck. You understand what I'm saying? So she's taking it upon herself to be sexually aggressive. And so that's one thing. Now, the second thing is to tell if a chick is down to fuck is that you, as the man, are, you know, you're initiating the sexual interaction and she's just going with it. So for example, let's say if you're at a bar or a club or whatever, or on a date or whatever it is, and let's say you start kissing a girl and then you pull her closer into you and you're like grabbing her ass while you're kissing her and she's letting it happen. And then, you know, let's say if you and her were like sitting at a booth or somewhere in the back of a bar and you're kissing her and then you start rubbing her crotch and she's letting it happen. You understand? Like, that chick is down to fuck. You feel what I'm saying? So it's either she is, you know, being sexually aggressive towards you on her own, or you are doing something sexual and then she's just flowing with it. You understand? So those are kind of like, you know, the two main ways to see if a chick is down to fuck. You feel what I'm saying? Also, but also you got to understand this is that, really the only way to tell it if a chick is really, 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 really down to fuck is when you're fucking her. Because there are times where a chick might be, you know, seem like she's down to fuck, where she's being all sexually aggressive, or you're, you know, bringing that out of her, you're being sexual and she's going with it. And then when it comes time to, you know, make it happen, they can, you know, change their mind. You feel what I'm saying? So that also happens. But generally, if a chick is being sexually aggressive and if you are bringing it out of her and you're being sexual towards her and she's letting it happen, usually it means she's down to fucking, usually it'll happen. Right? Now let's talk about, you know, how to get chicks back to your place, how to, you know, make it happen quickly or whatever. So when it comes to getting chicks back to your place, and also I talk about this in my DVD, The Bad Boy's Guide to Dating. So make sure you go to MrLocario.com right now and pick that up. But I'm going to talk about it a little bit here, is that when you're getting a chick back to your place, right? you know, there's two ways to do it. It's either indirect or direct. So the direct way is just basically letting her know, hey, I want to take you back to my place, or I want to go to your place, or whatever it is. And indirect is you giving an excuse as to why you guys should go back to your place, right? So direct will be like, let's say if you're at a bar with a chick, direct will be like, hey, you know, I'm having a really good time with you. You know, you should come back to my place right now. We should hang out a little bit more over there, right? So you're just letting her know directly that you want to take her back to your spot, right? Now, indirect is that you're giving a reason as to why you're going to back to your spot. So let's say if you are talking to the girl, and let's say y'all talking about astrology and she's into astrology, y'all talking about that shit. And you know, you could say something like, and let's say you got like an astrology book at your house somewhere or whatever. You could say, yo, you know, I got this really cool astrology book at my house. It has every day of the year and what that means. If you're born on that day, and you should definitely come check it out, you know, and you know, we should go back to my place and check out the book. So you're giving a reason why you're going back to, you know, your place. Now, the reason why you do it indirectly like that sometimes is also so that the woman can justify it in her mind as to why she's going to your place. Because in this society, we tell women they're sluts and they're whores and all that other crazy shit for fucking, and so they feel bad for fucking. So sometimes, even if the chick wanted to come back to your house, she will say no because she doesn't want you to think she's a slut or a whore. So this is why when you do it indirect, it gives her some rationalization and justification, so she can say, oh, well, I didn't go straight to his house to fuck him. I went to go see this astrology book. You understand? That's what she's going to think in her mind, right? So, you know, with the indirect way, it gives her a chance to basically justify it in her mind. Now, when you're dealing with the chicks, you know, you can kind of figure out which way you want to do it, you know, depending on the chick you're with or whatever. You can fill that out and see what works best for you, right? But those are basically like the two ways to do it. And you know, the way that it's easiest to get it to happen quickly also is to, you know, to do the indirect or direct, but also the best way I suggest is that when you, let's say if you take a girl out on a date or something, or you take her out and you kind of want to bring her back to your place, and then at night you're thinking about that, I always suggest to go to a place or bring her to a place that's near your house, that's like either in walking distance, or let's say like a 5 minute drive from your house is best. You understand? You know, if you're in a if you're in a city, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of things to do in a city area. You can go to like, you know, somewhere in the city area near your place that's gonna be quick from that place to your house or whatever. If you're in somewhere where you gotta take long drives or whatever, like say like, you know, like 10, 15, like 20 minutes, half an hour drive from this place to that place, then, you know, that's going to be a little bit longer, but you can still make it happen. But make sure, you know, you get in your car and get your ass over to the spot. You see what I'm saying? And again, you can still go over there and she still might, you know, shit might not go down. So just always, you know, just always understand that happens, so that you don't feel like, oh my God, what the hell's going on? Like, nah, that shit happens. You understand? You can go over there and she could change her mind, and it is what it is. You understand what I'm saying? And you just charge that shit to the game. You know, you understand? But usually when you tell a chick, hey, go come back to my place, you know, she know it's code for let's get it popping. You understand? And most likely, and usually she's down for that to go down. You understand what I'm saying? But in rare cases, you have the times where you go back there, and the shit still won't pop off. But just want to let you know that that also happens too. All right. So that is it. Also, guys, make sure you go to MrLucario.com and get my DVD, The Bad Boy's Guide to Dating, so you can get more information about this. Also, click the link below to get my free ebook, The Magnificent 10 Crucial Dating Tips for Men. And I will holla at you guys later. Remember, the truth is inside you. Peace.
Step up your dating game and join dating coach Mr. Lucario's Bad Boy and Bad Girl membership program. By becoming a member, you will receive 45 through 90 minute audio and video step-by-step dating advice tutorials every month that are guaranteed to help you get what you want out of your dating life. Go to MrLucario.com to join today. That's MrLucario.com. MrLucario.com.